Hi everyone, welcome back to the Scriptcase Macros course. This video is going to look at two different macros to manage the global variables inside of Scriptcase. So my name is Nate Carpenter and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this. So our first macro is the SC set global, and this allows us to set a Scriptcase global variable inside of our applications. And then the next one does the opposite, reset global, deletes a Scriptcase global variable. So let's go ahead and look at the documentation. So here's set global, our first one. And as you can see, it sets a global variable, so you assign the variable to it or the field, and then it's going to create a Scriptcase variable there. So as you can see, myvar equals Mary, and then set global for myvar, and that's going to create a Scriptcase variable with the same name as the PHP one, but it'll be accessed with the square brackets. We'll look at how to do that. And it's just registers session variables. So these are basically just session variables that we're setting here, but it's controlled within Scriptcase, so we can manage it with Scriptcase's tools. Let's go ahead and look at the reset one. So I'm going to go up to the top of the page here for the documentation. I'm going to scroll down and find, there it is, reset global. Let me click on that. So there it is. Pretty simple. You just pass in the variables that you want to reset. You can do as many as you can want as you want to separate them with commas. So over here, I have two basic applications set up. One that's going to display our variable that we're going to redirect to, and the one that we're going to set a variable. So I copy that code in that I copied from the documentation. Going to change the value here for this variable and make it so this is a SC global variable period, and then set it there with my var, and then I'm going to redirect to my other application here. And all this application does is it echoes out that Scriptcase variable, so it's going to redirect there and echo out that variable. And as you can see, it's in the square braces because it's a Scriptcase variable. So let's go ahead and run this. And it should redirect and display our variable. And there it is. So there's a value that we're getting from that second application. So it's a session variable, so it's accessible in both applications. Now we need to just go ahead and reset that after we output it here. So I'm going to go ahead and go back to the documentation. Let me copy this from the documentation and go back to my Scriptcase development environment. I'm going to reset it here. So I need to reset my var, that variable right there. So let me get rid of these and put it in there, and this should be good to go. Let me go ahead and generate the source for this so that it's ready to be redirected to with a new logic. And then let me do one more thing actually. Let's see here. So this is set up, it's going to redirect to it. Let's go ahead and prove that it's actually deleted. So now I'm going to go ahead and try and echo out that variable again. So now we should get it once, and then we'll get an error message because that variable is not set the second time we try to access it. So let's go ahead and go back to our first application and run that. And there we go. So it outputs it once, and then we get our error because that variable is not set. So it was deleted successfully. So that's how you set and reset global variables inside of Scriptcase.